Okay, so in this last video, we're going to create a truth table or a confusion matrix as a way of really kind of doing the assessment of error in your categorical maps. I'm kind of on a pledge to try to do everything these last couple weeks in free software. So we're going to wind up, you can do this in Excel, but I'd like to show you how to do it in Google Spreadsheets. And the main concept is a cross-tabulation. So by the end here, you're going to know you're done when you've done this step. Hopefully already here. And what I'd also like you to do is save a copy of your output from this in the Dropbox, and I want you to name it like this. You'll save it as an XLS, which is an Excel spreadsheet. So I guess I just broke my pledge, but you don't actually have to look at it. I'm going to look at your work in Excel. And you should try to do this truth table based on your own categorical map, the one that you interpreted and classified. But you may want to run through the tutorial first with Ben's work, just so that we're on the same page. Okay, so here's where we left off. If you open up the attribute table to the truth table values, you should have a table that looks like this. If you don't have this row here like this, please go back to the previous video, read the note, and redo it. There was an error with the data, but very few people, I think, will be affected by that. For the rest of you, if you have this, let's keep going. So let me talk about two ways to interpret this table. Again, labels represent the way the world is. Name column represents the way that we've represented that world. So the real world, the representation of the world. And if I sort on label just by clicking it, there's really two ways to think about error. One moves from left to right, and one moves from right to left. So if you look at this, here's a place that really is an apple tree, and we've marked that, we've represented that location on our map as an apple tree. We've done that pretty well, except for here. Here's our first error, according to this list. Here's a place that really is an apple tree. And we've represented that location as grassland in our map. So we can think about that in two ways. If we go from left to right, here's a place that truly is an apple tree that we've committed to the class grass. And going the other way, here's a place that we're calling grass because we've omitted calling it apples. Does that make sense? So if we keep going, here's another place that we've committed to the category grass, and it also represents a location on our map where we've omitted the true value of apple. Right? And so another way is if you sort it like this, you can see this again. Like, here's a place that really is grass that we've committed to the category apples. In the same respect, here's a place that we're calling apples that represents a missed opportunity to recognize what truly is crass. Okay, so there's this idea of kind of omission and commission as two different ways of thinking about error. Something that you've omitted and something that you've committed to something incorrectly. So let's make that those two concepts a little easier to visualize by getting out of this table and just changing the structure of our table. So what I'm going to do is go over to the truth table values and say save as. And I'm going to save this not as a shapefile, but as a comma-separated value. And then I'm going to browse, and I'm going to call this, I'm going to make sure I'm in the right spot, and I'm going to call this my truth table values. And I'm going to have the encoding be the same, the layers here as, I don't actually have to worry about this, because this is just going to kick out the attribute values. And I'm going to say OK. And at this point, you probably, can you even see it? Let's see, is this where my data is? Let's see, if I go to my W now 120, week 10, part 3, there it is, the truth table value CSV. So it's there, and that's good. I'm going to say save. And I'm going to minimize this. And now I'm going to open up a web browser. And I am going to go to, if I just type in Google, so I'm already logged in. I think I'm logged in under my, under JS Admin. And I'm gonna, so if you don't have a Google account, just make one. They're free. No reason not to have one. There's a lot of services that Google offers. And when you log in, go to Drive. And what we're gonna do is create a spreadsheet. So this is something again that you could do in Excel, but why not do it in a software that's free? So I'm going to go to File and then say Open, and then I'm going to go to Choose File, and let me minimize this for you. So I want to go to my folder where I've been working, which is my W account now, and then I'm going to go under Truth Table Values, my CSV, and open that up. And it's imported successfully, so I'm going to say Open Now. And great, so there's my attribute table. And there's a couple extra columns that we don't need to worry about. I'm going to try to select everything by clicking this box here, and that'll select my whole table. And then the next thing I'm going to do is go under Tools, no, Data, and say Pivot Table Report. The first thing I need to do is change my edit range, and I want to be able to edit or work with basically, this is going to say in Sheet 1, all of the rows in column A through C. And I'm going to say OK. And then what I'd like to do is make my rows be my classified map, or the world as I represented it to be or thought it was. And then I want my columns to be the world as it really is. So for rows, I'm going to add name, right? Because these are the names of the polygons in the categorical map that Ben classified. And then for my columns, I want to add label, because these represent the observation points and the world as it really is. And now what I want to do is cross tab the number of features that are listed as, apples on the map versus apples in the real world or in that point file. So if I say add values, I can just do ID, and then there's a little crazy, but then if I say summarize by count, now what I have is a table, and I could probably just highlight one, hold the sh shift down, cruise over, and make these, can I just make these a little bit smaller? Resize columns, and let's say these are just going to be 20. That's too small, so let's resize these. That's 60. Still a little too small, but better because at least now I can all see it, and I can see it in my window. Give it one last shot. 75. Okay. And so now what this is telling me is that 31 times I nailed the apples. But I also said in one case that what I've called apples on my map is actually part of the garden if you went there on the ground. And is it any surprise to you why I would have kind of a lot of error with grass, that the places that I'm calling apples on my map are actually grassland 23 times? This is reflecting our method of doing that buffer, right? And this video is not going to fit into just a single 15-minute slot. It's a couple minutes longer than that, so I'm just going to split it in two here. So continue over to the last video.